Hey guys, what's happening? Thanks for tuning in, coming back and watching. I appreciate it. And my friends at Skyloom have released an update to Luminar 4. It's now Luminar 4.1, and that's available today. And I could not talk about it because I like this stuff too much. So I thought I'd do a quick video. There are a few enhancements to the product that are kind of big-ish, if you will. And then there's a lot of performance updates and some smaller things. I obviously will not cover everything in this update, but they do have a blog post. I'll try to remember to put a link down below. And if for some reason I forget, just go check out the Skyloom blog and read all about it. But you can update quickly and easily within the app. It is a free update if you own Luminar 4. So 4 to 4.1 is a free update. If you're on Luminar 3 and don't yet have Luminar 4, you can get Luminar 4 at the link down below. Let's take a look at it. Here we go. If you're in Luminar 4, you can just click on the icon on the top left and click check for updates, and that'll tell you whether you're able to update yet. So I believe they're rolling it out across the globe. If you don't have it yet, you should be able to get it really soon. Okay, the first thing to talk about is there's a new slider added within AI Sky Replacement. So I'm going to click Sky Selection, and I want to put some clouds on this photo. It's kind of a, well, not kind of, it's a beach scene. It's kind of hazy. I'm gonna try, let's see, let's try Blue Sky 2. And here's the thing, when you have a hazy scene like that, when I put in this new sky, by the way, one other minor update is this little button here, and those, they, I think they're bigger, so seems easier to hit. Anyway, no clouds, and I added clouds, but there's, if you look at the original image, I mean, it's got this atmospheric haze in it, right? And when I put the new sky in, I don't have the haze in the new sky. I have it still kind of in the in this section along the beach. So there's a new setting for that. So click on Advanced Settings. It's called Atmospheric Haze. It's the opposite of dehaze. So dehaze allows you to kind of crisp up a photo and get rid of the haze and kind of cut through it. This Atmospheric Haze slider actually allows you to add haze to a photo. And it's a situation like this where you would want to do that because I love the blue and this and the clouds, the puffy clouds. I think they just look cool here. However, they don't match because it doesn't really go with the foreground. So you can just add atmospheric haze by dragging this slider. And there you go. You can see I've added haze. I can take it down or add it. And if I add atmospheric haze and move it kind of pretty high to the right in this photo, I think it works pretty well. And so that's the first thing that they've updated is adding atmospheric haze and in the AI Sky Replacement filter and allowing you to add that back to a sky that you've added, which I think is actually a really good idea. I'd never thought of it, of course, that it was necessary, but when you have a photo like that that has some haze and you put in a new sky, one more time I'll show you, if you don't have any haze in it, it doesn't really match, but maybe you want those blue clouds. So this slider will allow you to create haze in the clouds and allow it to better match the rest of the scene. Okay, the next update is actually to the erase tool. So if you caught my erase video, which I'll put a link to right up there, it works the same. So you can still use the tips and tricks that I put in that video to help you use the erase tool, but it's on the canvas tools. So you just click on canvas tools, click on erase, and there you go, you're in the erase tool. And so it is basically a more intelligent tool. It looks at the surrounding pixels and I think does a better job of putting in replacement pixels for you, which is what Erase does, right? It figures it out and decides on its own what it's gonna put in place of what you're erasing. Unlike Clone and Stamp, which you can watch a video about there, Clone and Stamp, you tell it which pixels to put in place. So Eraser works the same. You just, highlight over the object that you wanna erase. And one thing I recommend doing, if you have a lot of things you want to erase, is going through and erasing them one by one. So I'll highlight that little boat there and click erase, and it's gone. If you look at it, I think that did a really incredible job. I'll do another boat. So I'm gonna come over here and, I also recommend zooming in and taking your time, which I'm not really doing in this video, but regardless, I think that's a good tip to zoom in, slow down, and make sure you can do a good job with your brush. And once again, I think it did a great job. And so that's a quick demo. It's gonna be impossible for me to compare the two because I updated the app, so I don't have the old erase tool. I have the new erase tool. But I think go try it on some of your photos, check it out, see how it works for you. But More Intelligent does a great job of looking at surrounding pixels and figuring out what to replace with, and I think is much improved, which is something that I already felt like it was better than it was in Luminar 3, but now it's even more intelligent. So another free update for those of you that have Luminar 4. Okay, the next big thing is in the portrait enhancer tool. It's historically worked really well on, you know, a single or maybe two people in a photo, like a traditional portrait, but now it works better on group shots in terms of like face lightening and that sort of thing. So if you take a look at this, here's an example. I'll zoom in to give you a little bit more clarity around this, but if you look at face light, I'll just drag this, you can see their faces are getting lighter. So it's automatically detecting more faces and smaller faces within the frame. Same thing for slim face, that's gonna do the same thing. You see it's slimming the faces of all four of these gentlemen. So that's a great enhancement in the tool that it's allowing it to recognize smaller and larger quantity of faces. Okay, there's also a couple of things with layers. So I have this photo here and I'm just gonna do a couple of basic thing. I don't even know what, I'm just kinda winging it here. Let's see, I'll do something like that. Just a couple of base slider adjustments. There's now an adjustments amount slider on a layer, so you can see that you can do that. It also works if you add a new adjustment layer. So I add a new adjustment layer, I'm gonna grab a look, I'm gonna get this one, and I'm gonna close looks and apply that. And there you go, there it is, and now this adjustments amount is on this layer, and I can take that down. And it's basically like an opacity slider, but it, if you remember, there was something called filters amount in Luminar 3. This is kind of like that. So adjustments amount is nice to have because you might make a whole bunch of adjustments on your base layer or an adjustment layer and then think, yeah, I probably need to back that off. I was a little aggressive on some of the colors or whatever, which is something I do a lot. And so this is a great way to do that. Here's another thing that they did is, if you add a new image layer, I'm just gonna get a texture, which truthfully, I probably would not put a texture on this photo. This is from Prague. There's now an image opacity as well as adjustments amount. So adjustments amount is grayed out here because I don't have any adjustments on this layer. It's just an image layer, but I have this image opacity slider now. So it's a great way to help you blend things. I just stuck a texture on here just as an example, but if you're blending images, you can adjust the image opacity, and if there's any adjustments, you can also do adjustments amount on the image layer. If it's an adjustment layer, like down here, you will just have the adjustments amount. Great little addition, super handy, I think. Okay, going back to this original image, there's also a new aspect ratio that's available. You can see I straightened this photo. The new aspect ratio is 21:9, so you can see there, so it's very cinematic. If you have an incredibly widescreen monitor, for example, that would come in really handy, and I still actually don't think that's straight. I always have my photos crooked, it seems. Anyway, 21:9, or the reverse of that, which is 9:21, of course. I wouldn't need that here, but new aspect ratio, and if you like that, you just say done, and you're back to your regular photo. And honestly, it looks pretty cool with that really wide. I kind of like that. Okay, there's also some other minor updates, like the histogram's got a little bit better visibility. They're saying the same thing around the history panel. But there's also, let me get to this, here we go. If you just type in manual.skyloom.com, like that right there, you'll get to the Luminar 4 manual, and I get a lot of questions that I think you guys could probably also benefit from checking out the manual. I don't mind trying to answer them. Sometimes I don't have the answers and I go look in the manual. Wanted to make you aware of that. Also, when this first launched, by the way, this is like 320 pages. It's a massive amount of information, which is really great. But when it first launched, a lot of people were saying, but I want to download this. Okay, great. Download as PDF. You can now download as PDF. Other people say, well, what happened to the radiance filter? So you click on radiance and you can see, oh, okay, mystical. Okay, so it's now called mystical. And by the way, there's this really cool filter to tool migration. You can click on image radiance and you can see now it's under creative and it's called mystical. So this little filter to tool migration would help you figure out the answers to those questions, which is like, where's the whatever thing that I used to use or whatever? It'll help you figure that out. So super handy and super helpful. Okay, and that's it, my friends. A hopefully quickish overview of the updates to Luminar 4.1 and what's included. Definitely recommend that you go check for updates in app if you already own Luminar 4. It is a free update If you do not own Luminar 4, you would have to upgrade, which is a paid upgrade from a previous version of Luminar to get to Luminar 4.1. It's available today. Link down below if you need to upgrade, and a link down below for the blog post that outlines these updates as well as the other things that are included. And that's it, my friends. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it. I'll see you soon with more videos. Have a great day. Take care, and adios.